99, 100. It's so late right now. I should be in the studio recording. If only I had a magic portal. And that's how you get to work on time. Are you curious how we created the portal effect? It was definitely not with magical powers. We created the effect using video assets from the Shutterstock library, keyframes, chroma key, and blending modes. With PowerDirector's intuitive interface and creative editing tools, you too can easily create this Doctor Strange portal effect. Let's see how it's done. Hey you, get PowerDirector. It's free, and it's what the pros use. What have you got to lose? Setting up for this video is quite easy. First, make sure you use a tripod to keep your camera steady. Shoot extra scenes without the subject for the background. And when you set up your green screen, have even lighting so you can key out the green screen easily later on. Let's first learn how to edit our background scene. In PowerDirector, import a clip of your first scene on the main track and lock the track. Next, let's import a portal ring. Feel free to find video assets online, or you can also search and download them from the Shutterstock library in PowerDirector 365. In the Shutterstock library, input the keyword portal. Once you've downloaded a portal ring clip, find it under Media Content in the Downloaded tab and import it to Overlay Track 3. Select the portal ring clip on the timeline. Go to Tools, Blending Mode, and choose Screen. Open the PIP Designer and under Object Settings and Scale, uncheck Maintain Aspect Ratio so we can freely adjust the size of the portal. In the preview window, hold and drag the blue control points to distort the shape of the portal ring and click OK. Go to Mask Designer and mask the portal. Then lock Overlay Track 3. Next, import Scene 2, or your destination clip, to Overlay Track 2. Use the same method to distort the clip as we did with the portal ring in the preview window. And make sure the clip is able to fit the entire portal ring. Finish up by going to Mask Designer and mask the destination clip. Add some feathering to soften the edges. Next, let's see how to open the portal ring. Select the destination clip and open PIP Designer. Find a point in time when the portal is open and add an opacity keyframe. Then find a point in time when the portal has just begun to open and add another opacity keyframe and adjust the setting back to 0. Now let's make our subject walks into the portal ring. Import a green screen clip with your subject and open PIP Designer. Under Chroma Key, use the color picker to remove the green screen. Mask out the subject only and adjust the position in the preview window if needed. Trim the clip length to right when the subject walks into the portal ring and add a blur transition. If you want to enhance the effect even more, try adding some particles from the particle room. And that's it for our tutorial this time. I hope you've learned something new and enjoyed creating this effect. Let us know in the comments if there is any other movie effect you'd like to see us try. See you next time.